Hi students, the last class discussed about 8 physical quantities, what different type of 8 physical quantities, but in different motions. One is translatory motion or linear motion, another is rotational motion. So the last class discussed about number 1, displacement. We know that this is for angular displacement theta. Okay, then second one, velocity v, and angular velocity omega. Then third one, acceleration a, angular acceleration alpha. Next fourth one, mass m, moment of inertia I. Students, moment of inertia play same role, okay, like mass play in linear motion. So that this is very simple, mass and moment of inertia, then both are play same roles in different motions, linear motion in mass, but rotational motion in moment of inertia. But we know that students, moment of inertia, this is new word, I is equal to mk square. But we know that it is the product of mass and square of radius of gyration. Students, last class discussed about this definition, radius of gyration, k. So today discuss about the extra two physical quantities. So one is force, fifth one is force in linear motion. Students, you know that every person force F is equal dP by dt. Students, last class then discuss about velocity, V is equal to ds by dt. What is the definition of velocity? Okay, denominator time is there, the definition start must and should be the rate of. Students, the definition starting with the rate of change of displacement. The rate of change of displacement, it is called velocity. But students, what is P? P for momentum. We know that last class discussed about, it is the product of mass and velocity. Students, momentum means, this is the linear momentum. P is equal to M into V. We know that M for mass, friends, V for velocity. But we know that every person, what is the units of momentum? Mass units kg, but velocity units meter second minus 1. So this is for linear momentum. Okay students, then try to then definition. First denominator means the rate of. Okay, that's the definition starting with the rate of change of linear momentum. Change of linear momentum. Linear momentum is called as force. Students, we know that every person according to Newton's second law is also same. Okay, the external force is always directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. It is called Newton's second law. F proportional to dP by dt. It is called Newton's second law. So we know that every person proportional is cancelled. We know that every person constant one is k into dP by dt. Students, but P is equal to mv. Okay, this value substitute in above equation, F is equal to k into, okay, m is constant, m into dv by dt. So we know that every person, students, the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Acceleration, the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. So very simple, but A is equal to dv by dt. So F is equal to k into ma. Okay, by using of unit force, from unit force k is equal to 1. So students, F is equal to ma. This is the force formula. Students, then write, so F is equal to dp by dt is equal to what? Ma. This is for 8 marks question, students. So this is very simple definition for force. The rate of change of linear momentum is called as force, or The product of mass and acceleration is also called force. Okay, F proportional to dp by dt. This is for Newton's second law. Okay. So students, then try to understand the definition of Newton's second law. Okay, the external force or the applied force is always directly proportional to the rate of change of linear momentum. Is called as Newton's second law. Students, from the definition F proportional to dp by dp dt, proportional cancel, constant is k is there. But we know that every person linear momentum p is equal to mv. Substitute in above equation. Students, m constant, it is not differentiated. So f is equal to k into m into dv by dt. Students, we know that every person dv by dt is equal to a. So f is equal to k into ma. From unit force, we know that every person k is equal to 1. So f is equal to ma. This is very, very important. The fifth new physical quantity, force. So what is the units of force? Students, force units, F is equal to ma. So what is the units of mass? Kg. What is the units of acceleration? Meter second minus 2. Kg meter second minus 2. Students, kg meter second minus 2 is equal to Newton. So we know that every person on Newton. Newton is the scientist. Okay, we know that every person discovery of gravitational force. So what is the units of force? Newton. In SI system, what is the units of force? Newton. But in CGS system, what is the units of force? Dyne. Students, 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power of 5 dyne. 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power of 5 dyne. This is for force. Same type in rotatory motion. Okay, fifth physical quantity. Students, torque. So torque tau is equal to dl by dt. Students, what is L? L is angular momentum. L is equal to I omega. Students, L is equal to I omega. So what is the definition of torque? What is the definition of torque? Very simple. The rate of change of angular momentum is called as torque. The rate of change of angular momentum is called as torque. Students, what is the units of torque? It's okay. What is the units of torque? Newton into meter or Newton into meter or joule. What is the units of torque? Joule or Newton into meter? Newton into meter or joule. This is for new physical quantities. Students, okay, mass, okay, it is play some role in linear motion. The same role play in rotational motion by moment of inertia. Moment of inertia means I is equal to mk square. Students, mass units, we know that every person kg. But radius of gyration units meter. So square of k square. So kg meter square. Okay, next physical quantity, momentum. Momentum p is equal to mv. It is the definition very simple, students. It is the product of mass and velocity is called as momentum. Same type. In rotational motion, angular momentum. Students, this definition is also discussed in last class. So, it is the product of moment of inertia and angular velocity is called as angular momentum. So, what is the units of angular momentum? Joule into second. So it is the same units for Planck's constant. So next definition of force. Students, same type of definition. The rate of change of linear momentum is called as force. Students, if you write proportional, that is Newton's second law. This is very, very important, 8 marks question, students. So next and another important, torque. The rate of change of angular momentum is called as torque. Students, what is the units of torque?
Newton into meter or joule. Students, the small difference between work and torque. Students, what is the definition of work? Work is equal to F into S. This is the product of force and displacement. Students, work definition, it is the product of force and displacement is called as work. So what is the units of work? Newton into meter is equal to joule. Students, then observe, is very very important for JE mains and NEET. Okay, torque and work have the same units, but torque is vector quantity, work is scalar quantity. That is most important. Students, then observe, torque is vector quantity, but work is scalar quantity. Sir, quantity. Okay, the physical quantity have both magnitude and direction. It is called a vector quantity. So, what is the meaning of magnitude and direction? Suppose, for example, okay, then velocity. Velocity have direction and magnitude. But displacement have only magnitude. Distance have only magnitude but no direction. So distance is the scalar quantity. Velocity is the vector quantity. Same type, speed. We know that speed. What is the difference between speed and velocity? Speed means it is scalar quantity. Velocity means it is vector quantity. Speed has no direction, but velocity have both magnitude and direction. Then students, very simple. Vector quantity means the physical quantity have both magnitude and direction is called as vector quantity. But students, what is scalar quantity? The physical quantity has only magnitude but no direction. It is called scalar quantity. So both torque and work have the same units, but they are different type of quantities. It is vector quantity, this is scalar quantity. So work units joule and torque units also joule. Okay, the definition of work, we know that every person, it is the product of force and displacement is called as work. That's very simple. So next, now discuss about another two types of definitions. Students, actual, suppose for example, the important physical quantity, another important physical quantity, students, pressure. Students, pressure denoted by P. Actually, what is the formula of pressure? F by A. Students, it's very simple. Okay, the definition of the pressure. First, the definition start with the numerator, end with the denominator. Okay, end must and should be mentioned units. Okay, the force acting per unit area, it is called pressure. Students, then observe, some of the definitions start from the rate of, because of time is in denominator, the definition starting with the rate of. Okay, some of the definitions are starting with the product of. The different, another third type of definition, the definition starting with the numerator, end with the denominator, with the units. So the force acting per unit area, it is called pressure. Simple definition, students. Okay, this is also stress. So the restoring force, it is not force, normal force. The restoring force acting per unit area, it is called stress. Both have same units. Students, we know that every person, what is the units of force? SI unit of force is what? Newton. So students, Newton. What is the units of area? Students, area is equal to length into breadth. Volume is equal to length into breadth into height. Length units meter, breadth units meter, meter square. Student, volume units meter cube. So this is Newton per meter square is equal to Newton meter minus 2. Students, pressure is the most important physical quantity. The force acting per unit area, it is called force. Units Newton per meter square or Newton meter minus 2. Students, stress definition is also same. The restoring force, actually what is the meaning of restoring force? If apply the external force on duster, okay. If remove the external force, okay, the duster regains original position. Okay, the regains original position due to restoring forces. Due to restoring forces, students then observe, first the external force applied on duster, okay, the duster shape will be changed. If remove the external force, it regains original position. This body is called elastic body, students. One body regains original position due to restoring force. So then use restoring force. The restoring force per unit area is called as stress. Students, force unit already discussed in Newton. Area units meter square. So Newton meter minus 2, it is the units of pressure. Another units of pressure, atmosphere. Atmosphere denotes ATM, not any time machine, sir, madam. It is only for atmosphere. One atmosphere is equal to, how much the value of an atmosphere? 1.013 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square. Approx, one ATM is equal to 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square. This is the under units of pressure. So, one ATM is equal to 76 centimeter is also there. Okay, 76 centimeters. And another important, what is the CGS units of the pressure? We know that every person P is equal to F by A. Students, force units dyne. Area units centimeter square. This is for CGS units of pressure. Okay, this is very very important for 2 marks for IP exam students. Okay, the normal force acting per unit area, it is called pressure. The restoring force acting per unit area, it is called stress. Both have the same units, Newton meter minus 2. Another unit of pressure, atmosphere. One ATM is equal to approx 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square. Students, okay, this is new physical quantity, that is surface tension. Surface tension. Students, we know that every person, okay, if you observe the dirty water, the mosquitoes are walking on the dirty water. Because, okay, the surface of the water is tensionable. So, the property of surface of water, it is called surface tension. So surface tension denotes sometimes S R T. Actual surface tension S is called F by L. Students, this definition both are almost the same. The force acting per unit length, it is called surface tension. The force acting per unit length. Student, then observe. First definition show the rate of change of. Second type of definition show the product of. Third type of definition show per unit. This is for numerator, the force acting. Okay, this is for denominator. But okay, then numerator and denominator joined with the per unit. If you write any type of definitions, okay, any type of physical quantities, the ratios are there. The definition must be this type. Friends, the force acting per unit length, it is called surface tension. So, what is the units of surface tension? Force unit Newton, length unit meter. So, what is the units of surface tension? Newton per meter. But we know that every person, surface tension CGS unit, okay, force unit die, length units centimeter. Okay, students, then observe, one dyne per centimeter is equal to how many newton per meters? Students, then observe, one dyne per centimeter is equal to, one dyne is equal to, we know that every person, 10 to the power of minus 5 newton. 10 to the power of minus 5 newton. 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Minus 2 comes to numerator, plus 2. Okay, that is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 newton per meter. Students, 1 dyne per centimeter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 newton per meter. This is also most important 2 marks in units and measurements.
Writing ఒకటి గత్తర గత్తర అయితే అన్న బోర్డు గైపోతే